Anne spent a fortnight of halcyon days at Echo Lodge in the golden prime of August. While there she incidentally contrived to hurry Ludovic Speed in his leisurely courting of Theodora Dix, as related duly in another chronicle of her history. Arnold Sherman, an elderly friend of the Irvings, was there at the same time, and added not a little to the general pleasantness of life. "What a nice playtime this has been," said Anne. "I feel like a giant refreshed, and it's only a fortnight more till I go back to Kingsport and Redmond and Patty's Place. Patty's Place is the dearest spot, Miss Lavendar. I feel as if I had two homes, one at Green Gables and one at Patty's Place. But where has the summer gone? It doesn't seem a day since I came home that spring evening with the Mayflowers. When I was little I couldn't see from one end of the summer to the other. It stretched before me like an unending season. Now 'tis a handbreadth, 'tis a tale." "Anne, are you and Gilbert Blythe as good friends as you used to be?" asked Miss Lavendar quietly. "I am just as much Gilbert's friend as ever I was, Miss Lavendar." Miss Lavendar shook her head. "I see something's gone wrong, Anne. I'm going to be impertinent and ask what. Have you quarreled?" "No. It's only that Gilbert wants more than friendship, and I can't give him more."
"Are you sure of that, Anne?"
"Perfectly sure."
"I'm very, very sorry."
"I wonder why everybody seems to think I ought to marry Gilbert Blythe," said Anne petulantly.
"Because you were made and meant for each other, Anne, that is why. You needn't toss that young head of yours. It's a fact."
End of chapter 23. Chapter 24. Enter Jonas. Prospect Point, August 20th. "Dear Anne, spelled with an E," wrote Phil. "I must prop my eyelids open long enough to write you. I have neglected you shamefully this summer, honey, but all my other correspondents have been neglected, too. I have a huge pile of letters to answer, so I must gird up the loins of my mind and hoe in. Excuse my mixed metaphors. I'm fearfully sleepy."